Hello. As we know, global warming is a major problem against which we must all take action. So even though aviation accounts for less than 3% of greenhouse gases linked to human activity, it's nonetheless crucial to strongly reduce its carbon footprint, or even totally eliminate it. Every player in the sector is mobilized and working towards the decarbonization of air transport, with carbon neutrality as the target. Of course, this is a colossal challenge, but solutions already exist. For example, replacing classic kerosene by so-called sustainable fuels, a particularly interesting solution because it's applicable to existing planes or planes currently in production. They're called sustainable aviation fuels, or SAFs, to initiates. Among the alternatives to kerosene, there are firstly biofuels. Some of them, products of agriculture, are undoubtedly familiar to you. Like, for example, ethanol, an alcohol made from sugar beet or maize. But while they're ideal for heating your home or running certain cars, these fuels aren't adapted to the demands of aircraft engines, so they can't be used directly. Another constraint we must address is that of the availability of the raw material. Indeed, considering the amount of kerosene to replace in order to meet the needs of air transport, it's necessary to turn to biofuels that can be produced in vast quantities while preserving the environment and whose manufacture doesn't enter into competition with agribusiness crops. So we must prioritize the use of new raw materials like, for example, salicornia, a plant that grows in salt marshes, jatropha, a bush from Brazil that grows in arid zones, camelina, or even oil extracted from certain microalgae. But there is one natural energy source that's available in a very large quantity, the exploitation of which is being prioritized today, and that's the biomass. That's right, it's the same principle as for compost. The biomass includes organic matter from both plants and animals, which is then transformed not into fertilizer, but into energy. Using the biomass to create biofuel is an excellent way to recycle certain household waste and certain waste from agriculture and forestry. Once collected, this waste is transformed using different processes, such as pyrolysis, gasification, and liquefaction. It's then turned into fuel with traditional refining tools. These new fuels are called drop-in fuels, meaning they can be mixed in various quantities with classic kerosene. They're compatible with all aircraft, even helicopters, and are used in all of the world's airports. But even if biomass is available in large quantities, it's crucial to have alternatives available, like synthetic fuels. Synthetic fuel is made by combining hydrogen with carbon dioxide that comes either from industries, like the smoke from factories, or captured directly from the atmosphere. This way, we obtain synthetic kerosene that's perfectly compatible with airplanes currently in service. While Safran is strongly involved in the development of this promising technology, its engineers are looking even further ahead and are working on the design of future hydrogen engines. Hydrogen emits only steam, so this process has very bright prospects, although it will require aircraft architecture to be totally reconsidered so as to load and store hydrogen. As you can see, the future is in the present. And all sustainable fuels constitute a genuine revolution for aviation. And for the planet, of course. There, now you know everything. Or almost. But before we go, remember that while sustainable fuels are promising, the least polluting fuel is the fuel that airplanes don't consume. Research is ongoing to design airplanes that are less energy consuming, and perhaps tomorrow, who knows, each of us may even be able to contribute directly to the manufacture of fuel.